worship him. Lord, we exalt you, Lord. Lord, we exalt your holy name. There is no one to be compared with you. You are the King of glory. You are the great I am that I am. The bright and the morning star. We exalt you, Lord. 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 There is no one to be compared with you. Oh, blessed be God. Oh, blessed be God. Oh, blessed be God. Hosanna. Magnify your name this morning, this afternoon, this evening, oh Lord, this night, whatever the world, wherever your children are, Lord, we bless your holy name together. We bow before you, Lord, in adoration. We thank you for your loving kindness that is better than life. We thank you, Lord God Almighty, because you are worthy. You are worthy of everything, Lord. We bless your name, sweet God. Glory be to your holy name. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we thank you for bringing us to the 14th hour of the 21 hours, Lord. In the 9th hour with you, the call that you gave to us to come to you, Lord God Almighty, we are grateful. It is your doing, it is marvelous in our sight. Thank you for your encouragement. Thank you for your support, oh God. Thank you for how far you have brought us, Lord. Glory be to your holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we come to you just as we are, Lord God Almighty. And yes, the Lord, you will test us, oh Lord. You will search us, oh Lord. You will examine us, oh Lord. And see if there be any wicked way in us, Lord. Whatever is not of you, Lord, we ask the Lord God Almighty. You will show us your mercy. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your blood wash us clean, oh God. Sanctify us inside and outside. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, precious Redeemer. Have your way in our lives, oh Lord. Thank you for your son over there, your church and over there, and the entire family, the ministers of God over there. And yes, Lord God Almighty, you will gather us indeed to yourself. Lord, and speak to us, Lord, and strengthen us to continue prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for the networks. Thank you for all the airwaves, so Lord. And yes, Lord, you will take preeminence. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, lay your hands on me, sit on me, wrap yourself, Lord, around me, Lord God Almighty. I have no strength of my own. I have no power of my own, Lord. Lord, I depend on you, Lord God Almighty. Let me disappear and you appear. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, precious sweet dad. Glory be to your holy name. We are trusting you, Lord God Almighty, that indeed everyone, oh Lord, over there, Lord, they will have reason, oh Lord, to lift their hands and say, indeed, we have been with Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The rapture will take place while we are here, Daddy. Please let everyone, oh Lord God Almighty, qualify to be with you at last. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We love you, Dad.
Yes, Lord.
We love you forever.
Yes, Lord.
Glory be to your holy
name.
But in Jesus Christ's unchallengeable name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you, my precious family. And thank God for your life. By the grace of God, we are still praying in the ninth hour with Jesus. And today is the 14th hour. See how far the Lord has brought us. Some of us were afraid when we started. But by the grace of God, we have come this far.
Amen.
And we are going to finish well in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's not going to be easy. It's not easy. I know. There are temptations. There are things that are trying to distract us. And it is normal. The devil knows that the more you can pray, the more you will limit him. The devil knows that you limit him with prayer. And that is why, by the grace of God, nobody's going to distract us.
Amen.
We'll be focused.
Amen.
Because prayer is a very personal victory. It's not a victory for crowd. Because we can be in a crowd, but we don't know the heart of the other person. But if you are focused on God, like blind Bartimaeus, he was in the midst of the crowd, but he got the attention of God. Child of God, God Almighty is calling us to personal focus in the place of prayer.
Amen.
And we're not going to disappoint God.
Amen.
He has confidence in us. That is why he called us.
Amen.
We are starting by 3 p.m. today because it is the ninth hour, 3 to 4 Nigerian time. Then we're going to have a break for 2 hours to come for the soul meal, the broadcast, the prayer from 6 p.m. to 8 or thereabouts, as the Lord will help us, Nigerian time.
Amen.
So please, don't go too far away. After the prayer, 3 to 4, we are coming back.
Amen.
By 6 p.m. by the special grace of God in Jesus Christ tarries and keeps permitting us.
Amen.
So God Almighty has called us today to establish us in faith.
Amen.
That's why he called us, to prepare us for the global revival. There can be no revival in the globe if you don't have personal revival.
Yes.
It's individuals that make up the church.
Yes.
It's families that make up the church. And God Almighty is preparing us as individuals and as family.
Amen.
And by the time we come together, the explosion of the revival will begin to take place.
Amen.
So by the grace of God, God Almighty has a word for us today. We're going to read our theme scripture, which is Hosea chapter 10, verse number 12.
Sow to yourselves in righteousness.
The Lord is saying we should sow. It's our responsibility. Sow to yourself in righteousness.
Reap in mercy.
Because for every sowing, there is a reaping.
Yes.
For every sowing, there is a reaping.
Yes.
And God Almighty is calling you and I to sow in a specific way, which is to sow in righteousness.
Amen.
So that we will reap in mercy.
Amen.
The mercy of God is what you are looking for.
Yes.
Without the mercy of God, child of God, we will fumble in this world.
Yes.
We'll not be able to meet up with the demands of living in this world at this particular point in time, because we are in perilous times.
Yes.
And so God Almighty is calling you and I that it is time for us to stand with him in the place of prayer.
Amen.
So he can strengthen us.
Amen.
And make us what he wants us to be.
Amen.
And by the grace of God, we'll be focused in the name of Jesus
Christ.
A blind man can be focused without physical eyes. How much more you and I, most of us here, we can see with our physical eyes. So we're not going to allow anybody to distract us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So we'll reap in mercy.
Break up your fallow ground, for it is time to seek the Lord.
That is what we are going. We are the ones that we break it up. Not any preacher for us. We have no representative. We're the ones that are going to break up the fallow grounds. Because God Almighty has something he has put inside of us. and he knows that we can carry it out. Yes.
See, he come and rain righteousness upon
the Lord God Almighty. Amen. He said he will come and rain righteousness.
Amen.
Beware of people who are tracking your mind to this world in materialism. He said he was coming to reign righteousness. He's specific with what he promised. No, many of us are disappointed in God because somebody prophesied something to you that God didn't say. So it makes you be disappointed. You see, but God said, God did not say. Even the devil said, God said. Did God say? Anybody can say, God said. So beware of God said. God told me. There are so many revelations on social media. I had one, was it yesterday? They said, God told me that in the month of May, everybody should be ready. Be careful of all these prophecies and revelations. God is not there. There are false Christs. There are false teachers. They are everywhere. It is a major sign of end time. Diverse revelations. Let us stick with the Bible. God cannot go wrong. This word has been tried, 7 times purified. This word raises the dead. This word is Jesus Christ. And if he is in you and I, let us trust the word. He will not lead us astray with the word. Leave these prophecies and all this revelation. Put them aside. Don't allow them to distract you from your Jesus. Because God has a word for us today. The Lord is asking us a question. And he said, who will make heaven? The Lord gave me a secret about who will make heaven. I have been so excited since I received this message from the Lord. Who will make heaven? Today, God will tell us who will make heaven.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's the ultimate child of God, is to make heaven.
Yes.
Not that I am born again. Born again that will not make heaven. You will see who will make heaven. It's in the scripture. God has people that he is looking at their hearts. That he knows this one will make heaven. Not only not pray for Judas Iscariot, he prayed for Peter. If only people like King Saul had known these secrets that I'm about to share that God gave to me, he would not have died a useless death. He would not have been dethroned. He would not have been replaced. He would have finished well. If only King David had known what I'm about to share with us now that God gave to me, he would have lost that child from that woman that he killed, the husband. And he would have been the one to build the temple because God loved him. What is the secret of God? Go to the book of Revelation chapter 3 verse 19. If we pick this secret child of God, you will make heaven. You will see what God is going to tell us.
Revelation chapter 3 verse 19.
Yes.
As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten.
Jesus Christ is talking to the churches. He said, angel, go to these churches. Go and give them message per church. Every church has what God is seeing there. Every church is so painful that you see churches copying each other. It's of copying Christ. So that God will judge them based on how they are relating with him. He sent this angel to this church and said what?
As many as I love.
As many as I love. Not we love. There's no three gods there. I went to somewhere today for a wedding and the preacher there was wedding them in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. That wedding is null and void. Because the name that is above every other name is not mentioned. They didn't mention Jesus Christ. So demons have power in that marriage. But I pray God will deliver them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He says, as many as I love,
I rebuke.
Another I again, I rebuke.
And chasten.
And chasten. Child of God, rule number one. If you know that God loves you, you believe that God loves you, you sing songs like excess love, you sing songs like, oh, he loves me. I cannot say why God said, then he wants to see me at last, submit to rebuke. Submit to chastening. Submit to my divine flogging. This is rule number one. Don't hide your sin. Don't be afraid of punishment. Don't use your personality to cover your sin. Don't use your gifts, your status in the society, your post in the church, your spiritual achievement. Don't use it to block your sin. I have seen you. I know you. The same me that I've been taking care of you, I now want to rebuke you. I want to chastise you. I want to correct you. I want to shout on you. If you pass this test, then you can enter part two.
Jesus.
If you can accept God's correction, God's rebuke, automatically you will enjoy part two, because part two will lead to part three.
Amen.
If you will not walk away and get angry, if you will say, Lord, you are qualified to rebuke me, you are qualified, after all, you are the one that woke me up this morning, I would have died and I cannot do anything about it. You woke me up this morning, you are permitted and you are qualified to chastise me, to shout at me, to point my sin to me. Yes.
Be zealous therefore and repent.
Hey, God Almighty himself getting zealous and walking away, getting zealous and going to complain to people, getting zealous and changing church up and down just because I look at people that go to bet you. He said, repent. Mm-hmm. What do you mean of be zealous? Quickly. Do it quickly. Don't postpone repentance. Who will make heaven? The one that repents quickly. The one that does not postpone repentance. The one that is not afraid of punishment. The one that reports himself to God. By the grace of God, I thank God for my last child, my daughter. That girl has taught me about Christ. If she does anything wrong, she does not wait for somebody to come and rebuke her. She reports herself. She comes and says, Mommy, I'm sorry. She reports, by the time she reports herself, I cannot get so angry with her because she was not caught. Somebody did not report her. Many of us are in bondage because somebody knows your sin. So you forced yourself to love them, to give them gifts, and they can be hiding your sin. For how long? Hey, for how long will you be petting that doctor who knows about your abortion? For how long will you be petting that pastor who knows about your sin? God Almighty, report yourself to me. David was busy defending himself that he is king. It had to take God to send Prophet Nathan to go and tell him that he is a man. If only David had said, Lord, I have sinned. Nathan wouldn't have even heard. He would have settled himself with God. It is time for you and I to begin to report ourselves to God. Don't wait for the preaching before you repent. You will not make heaven. No man knows the day nor the hour. Immediately you are pricked in your heart that this thing you have done is sin. A true child of God has what they call police officer. It is called conscience. The conscience of man is God's security officer. God is the one that employed the conscience and said, go there and monitor Kechi. When she does something bad, that is a sign that you have God in you. Repent. Lord, I am sorry. Don't cover it. Don't kill him. Many people have killed your own police officer. Because anyone that speaks the truth is killed. It's difficult to keep people that speak the truth around you alive. You kill them. You show them hatred. Showing somebody hatred is killing the police officer. When you block them, when you don't want them to talk, when you show them that anger so they'll be afraid of confronting you, you have killed somebody. You have killed your conscience. You have made yourself to become a God. Child of God, the greatest blessing of a man's life is to be so open that somebody can talk to you. Somebody can correct you. Somebody can rebuke you. Don't put yourself in a position where nobody will talk to you. You will miss heaven. You will miss heaven. The Lord said, who will make heaven? It is the one who is zealous in repentance. Not zealous for church program. Not zealous to go and have a post. Not just going to give testimony. The one that is zealous fast in repenting. That is why a Christian who has stopped repenting has started dying. You can't make heaven. Repentance keeps your spirit alive. Repentance makes you to be more and more a Christian. When you stop repenting, you become religious. You become churchy. You begin to use activities and all this your business to cover for your spiritual life, and your soul is crying. Your soul feels free when there's mercy, when there's forgiveness. You don't assume. You don't say, we all will make heaven. It's a lie. You cannot use that fake speech to cover for your sin. We all will make heaven is a word of the pride. The proud. Proud people say, we all will make heaven. There's no place like that in the scripture. It's a personal race.
Yes.
Go through the scripture. You will see that people that easily repented, God loved them. Is that Prince Peter?
Yes.
Peter repents so fast. But Judas will harden his heart. Who will pray for him? People like Thomas, they will open up and say, I don't believe till I see. And when they see, they say, my Lord and my God, they repent immediately. They don't defend themselves. They don't give reason like Saul. Saul will give reason. It is the people. If only that little space, he had used it to say, Lord, I am sorry. But eventually, God would have forgiven him. All the long story God was talking to Adam and Eve, if only they had said, oh Lord, we are sorry, there would have been no need for Jesus to come. He would have restored them in the Garden of Eden. It was their hardness, because sin hardens the hearts. Because he has named all the animals, he has power. Eve was so familiar with God, because they were having fellowship every day. Shall I beware of your confidence in yourself because of your spiritual attainment, because you can pray, you can preach. Beware of those things, because it will make you to hate God. You will not respect God. You will not honor God. And you will end up in hell. The Lord Almighty said this period of revival is a period to become very, very fast in repenting. Don't wait for somebody to come and convict you. Don't wait for a donkey. Don't wait for a donkey to push you first before you repent. You may not survive it. You may have a broken leg. Don't wait for fish to swallow you. You may not be able to bear it. Fast repentance produces the mercy of God. As you are sowing in righteousness. Because when you sow in righteousness, you are sincere. You are not bragging. You don't hope on your past. You are seeing things the way God is seeing things. You are open for your fallow grounds to be revealed for you to break. The Lord said, Kechi, you want to make heaven? Don't postpone repentance. Don't wait till the time is convenient. Immediately I touch you, or I send somebody to preach and you hear, immediately cry and say, I am sorry. Don't waste time. Every time I practice it, it works. Hey, Kalaboko, so that no matter how small it is, it works. Just tell me, I'm sorry, Lord, I'm sorry. You told me to pass this road. I didn't obey. I came to pass this road. Lord, I am sorry. Immediately the Lord will clear the road. I've seen it. Repentance produces God's mercy. The soft part of God is inside repentance. Not in crying. You can cry, I am repenting. So when they cry that we cry, it is just to get sympathy from people and just to look holy and look broken. But you know you're not broken. You know your heart is hard. Repentance comes from inside. Repentance is a decision never, it's a regret and a decision never to repeat. That's it. When you find that you keep repenting, say, you have not repented, child of God. Repetition of sin is a sign of lack of repentance. It has not pained you enough. Do you know that there are different cane for various pain? As a mother, there is a way a child will offend. You can tell the child, why do you do that? But there's something a child will do. You will go and look for your high heel shoe to hammer the child, because the pain you are getting from that action is so big that ordinary slap cannot carry it. You look for a big weapon to discipline. Many people have killed their children because of that. They beat the child, they go and use belt. Fathers, they will use belt. That is demonic, sir. Don't praise yourself. Okay. You see them, they will say, is it me you talk to? Is it me you are talking to? They are eyeing me. They are losing their belt. And then they will do it, including pastors. Absolutely, including pastors. They will begin to flog the child. And the child will have marks all over the body. And if the child has to go and meet a neighbor or anybody, they will beat both neighbor and the child. Yes. Because of the painfulness of what the child has done. Child of God, God Almighty is calling you like that. Don't wait for a big thing before you repent. Repent for small things. Repent for assuming. Apologize. Don't assume anything. Don't take for it. If it is a widow that you offended, a small widow, don't have money. Apologize. Don't say, who is she? Because she's still coming and begging money. Apologize. I remember one day my driver, I don't know what my driver did, I can't remember, some years ago. I was so angry with the driver, I hit the driver like this, bam, on his shoulder. The Lord said, I've left you, you're gone. Go and apologize. I said, I apologize. I gave the driver a gift. The Lord said, that is not apology. He will tell me, get up, tell you, thank you, mommy. But you must open your mouth and apologize. That is when your name will be clear in the book of life. Yeah. Child of God, I thank God that God has helped me.
Amen.
I can apologize to rabbits. Rats. I can apologize to rats. It's not hard for me anymore. Why? God told me, the easier you repent, the more you are likely to make heaven. God will not show mercy. God will not do a special partiality for you. He gave the scripture to himself. He said, I will be gracious to whom I'll be gracious unto. I'll be merciful to whom I'll be merciful unto. God will not give a special partiality to monitor your life so that you can make heaven. God will do it.
Amen.
He is the one that gave himself that prayer, that special scripture. Child of God, do you hate rebuke? You don't like correction? You easily block people that correct you. You shout at people. The words that I've shown in recent times are youths, their mouths have become very sharp. Youths abuse, insult. Hey, kalabokosuntaya. What have you seen in life of youths and young ones? I weep in my heart. No iota of respect. Spirit of end time and last days. They don't have, especially now that old men prefer teenage girls to have sex with them. So these teenage girls that have seen the private part of billionaires, of rich people, of governors, of pastors, they have no regard for human beings. They have seen big things, so nobody's anything to them. They have seen 60-year-olds, rich people, that people are kneeling down for the heart, multitude of staff. They have seen them kneeling down to ask them for sex. So they have no regard for her. They've seen her little, as small as they are. They've seen her elderly men carry them. And my baby, carry them to this shopping. They'll be picking iPhone. They will pick watch. They will pick designer. They've seen how an old man with gray hair like me worship them. They have no regard for anybody. God will restore our teenagers.
Amen.
Will restore our youths.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We're going to pray today because God Almighty said we're going to break up our fallow grounds.
Amen.
That is why I'm begging you, please, before you begin to be asking God for big things, asking God for money, asking God for prosperity, wealth, want you to go and get married, deal with your spirits. Be broken enough to say, I am sorry. Without being cajoled, without being pushed. I had to beg a teenager yesterday to say, I'm sorry. She said, okay, I'm sorry, ma. Once you say, okay, I am sorry, you're not apologizing. You're apologizing. There's no, that's an apology. That is pride. Okay, miss, is that what you want? Okay, take it now. You don't say, okay. And then when people say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. What else do you want? Hey, it's what I see with teenagers, youth. They do not have one iota of fear. Fear of God is gone. So you know that they are doing all these motivational speeches and telling them that their work does not, and God cannot, what God cannot do does not exist. And boosting them and making them to be so big-headed and they are seeking for miracle. I heard a musician, I saw a musician on social media, one of these big musicians in Nigeria. He's not married, he's single. He put himself with a young lady and a son and said, God is taking care of us. And somebody asked him, who is that girl? Are you married? He said, what God cannot do does not exist. That is his answer to promote whatever he's advertising there. Because Bible says in Philippians 4:5, let your moderation be made known to all men. Let people know, because the Lord is at hand. Let people know, is that girl your wife, or is your concubine, or is your girlfriend, or is your living lover? Who is that child you're carrying? And this program and sing songs like, you are too faithful to fail me. God Almighty will purge his church.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Are you soft in God's hand? Do you easily repent? Then God say, heaven belongs to you.
Amen.
He said, be zealous, be quick. He said, come and report yourself to me. When you have done something, don't wait for somebody to come and report to you. Don't hide under the bondage of somebody. If somebody is holding your sin, you can never be free. Let people that know your sin know that you have reported. That God is aware of it. They are not ashamed of it. Be bold to tell them, that is only my boyfriend. That is me, my lesbian partner. That is be bold to declare, sister, that child that you're carrying up and down and saying it's your mother's last born. It's your child. Yeah, Kalapa. You want to go and marry? Yes, and you're carrying a child and lying to the man. It is your mother's last born. Yeah, Kalapa. So that God cannot bless you. It is time for us to begin to break our fallow grounds of hardness of heart and begin to repent fast. Somebody say fast.
Fast.
Fast. Quick repentance. People like fast food, fast lane, fast truck. They don't want fast repentance. God has himself for fast repentance. Yeah. Don't waste time. Yeah. That time you are wasting, the trumpet can sound. Mm-hmm. But if God, because before you talk, your heart is talking. Mm-hmm. So if I tell you, I say, I'm sorry, your heart has already said, I'm sorry. And God Almighty is faithful. He knows when it's good to sound the trumpet. The righteous in heart will not miss it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. Once your heart is repenting, it will show. People will not go. Nobody's going to ask you. Nobody's going to ask you. On your own, you will repent. You will speak forth. The Lord said that is the secret. So who will make heaven is the one that can accept chastity.
Yes.
And be zealous. And be fast. To repent, and God Almighty will receive him.
Amen.
Will receive her.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let's go to God in the place of prayer. Go to God in the place of prayer and begin to thank God. Appreciate God for his word. Appreciate God for this 14th hour out of 21 hours. The Lord is bringing us a word. He said it is time to prepare for the global revival. It is time to prepare. We are preparing, and that is why God is telling us the secret. You cannot be a global revivalist when you are hearted in the place of repentance. We cannot stop talking about repentance, because that is the ultimate to making heaven at last. Child of God, lift your voice to God and Father, thank you. Appreciate God for this secret. King David did not know this secret. King Saul did not know this secret. Lift your voice and cry to God. God Almighty Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for every hardness. Every time I resist that repentance, I ask, what have I done? I always ask, what did I do wrong? You feel you must know what you did wrong. Don't you know that you can have an impure touch? And that you can have a proud look? God Almighty is calling you now. You do not need to ask, what did I do wrong? You only need to reap in mercy. You only need to reap in mercy. That's what we need. We need the mercy of God. Hey, say, Lord, I am sorry. I repent to God of delaying, the Lord, in my repentance, O God. Child of God, delayed obedience is rebellion. When you delay to repent, you are rebelling against God. You are saying, what can he do? You are beginning to give yourself credit. You are boosting your image. You are boosting your personality. The devil will crush you until you begin to receive that special spirit from God of repenting easily. Don't allow the devil to harden you by crushing your conscience. Your conscience is God's security officer. It's God's police officer. Your conscience, don't kill your conscience. Don't kill your conscience, child of God. The Lord God Almighty gave it to us as a gift. It's a gift, it's a gift in this world. Lord God Almighty, have mercy on me. I repent of hardness of heart. I repent, in Jesus Christ. Mighty name we are praying. Child of God, you can be sure. All the servants of King David, they didn't see anything wrong in what the master did, the king did. You can be sure that all those that were with King Saul, they never saw what he did as wrong. You cannot tell what God is seeing in your life and in my life and say, no, this cannot be. But he's faithful. He gives us the conscience as a security officer to prick us. You are going to cry to God. The Bible says the men, after hearing the teaching and the gospel of Apostle Peter and the people and the brethren, in the book of Acts chapter 2, 37, the Bible said they were pricked. They were pricked. They were not angry. They received the teaching. It wasn't the prophetic message. There was no sugar in the teaching. It was a hard teaching. God read the book of Acts chapter 2. After they received the Holy Ghost, he told them how they killed Jesus Christ. A very difficult message to consume, but they took it. They took it and they became sinners. Child of God, don't drag your feet in repentance. Allow the word of God to break you. The God of God says, Father, restore. What makes heart to break?
What makes
the heart to break? When you hear the truth of God's word, restore my own. Child of God, you need the word to restore. You have killed your own with self-defense. You have killed your own with the pride of life. You have killed your own with your spiritual gifts. You have killed your own with how they praised you before. You have killed your own. You are not having it anymore. Hey, Kalababalateya. Cry to God and say, Father, restore the breaking heart. The breaking heart that will be breached by the truth of your word. Lift your voice and pray to God. Hey, Kalababalateya. Hey, Kalababalateya. Lord, I cry to you, Lord. Restore the breaking heart of God. To me, O Lord, my family. To my children, O God. All your children, the global altar. Restore the breaking heart of God. Restore the breaking heart of God. Rakalaboko Sote. In Jesus Christ. Mighty name we are praying. Child of God, don't be a fair weather Christian. Don't be a Christian that only wants good things from God. That is what Job called his wife. Don't be like these silly women. When you love only the good things of God, you are silly. You are not fit for the kingdom of God. God Almighty said, as many as I love, it doesn't love everybody. It doesn't love everybody. It's as many as I love. It didn't say I love everybody. Yeah, it is a privilege for God to just tune you. It's a privilege for God to correct us, to rebuke us. He said, as did you see him rebuking Judas? He said, Judas, go and do what you want to do. It's a dangerous situation for God to tell you, go and do what you want to do. Continue with your sin. Continue with your wickedness. When God Almighty begins to rebuke and even call you Satan, like he called Peter, it's a sign of love. Yes. That is love. Love is not in a matter of words. Love is in early prevention from destruction. If God Almighty allowed Peter to continue to rebuke Jesus, how can you rebuke your master? I don't say he was rebuking Jesus. I'm telling him you cannot go to the cross. The very reason why he came, he confronted Jesus' destiny. If God had let him to go, he would have been destroyed. He will never make heaven. He will never be an apostle. That preached the first sermon. That saved 3,000, about 3,000. You are going to grant to God, my God, and I say, Father, don't stop loving me. Keep on loving me, Lord. With rebuke, with chastening. And lift your voice, I pray to God. Somebody can pray over there. Lord, don't stop loving me, Lord. Love me, rebuke. Love me, chastening. Love me, correction. Love me, Lord. Rekalaboko sote. Rata na galiba muso. Eka na gagaga. Raka gagaga la teya. Love me, Lord. Love me, Lord. Love me, Lord. Love me, Lord. Raka gagaga. Raka la 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 la. Raka la 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 muso teya. Love me with correction, Lord. Love me with rebuke, Lord. Ina na na muso kala mama te. Hey, Jesus Christ, mighty day we are praying. Child of God, God knows that we are not yet perfect. He is the one that is perfect. He only said, be thou perfect. He said, encouraging us to walk towards perfection. We cannot afford to claim perfection. Learn to accept fault. Learn to accept error. Anyone who feels that they are perfect, you cannot easily say, this is what I did. You don't know how to report yourself. You want to be hiding your sin. He said, let them not notice you. Let them not notice you. Once as a child of God, I said, let them not notice you. You love sin. Why shouldn't they notice? You are manipulative. You are not a child of God. I want to continue in evil. Don't you know that he that covereth his sin shall not prosper? It is he that openeth the sin. I confess it. That shall obtain the mercy of God. Why do you pray for your husband not to know what you are doing? You will not make heaven. Because the secret will come out one day. The Lord is hidden that will not come out. When you are telling the dark, will come out to the broken light. Why you postponing shame? You are postponing disgrace. One day it will come. This is a time to report yourself to God. Child of God, learn to accept correction. Learn to accept rebuke. Don't defend it. Don't prove anything. Don't get angry and walk away here. Don't keep malice. Don't become melancholic. Melancholy is not repentance. You can look so evil, but you're not repentant. It is a sign of pride. Lift your hand, Christ, and say, Father, help me to surrender to your rebuke. Help me to see myself. I am not yet perfect. I am walking to perfection. Help me, Lord God Almighty, to humble myself in the place of chastening, in the place of rebuke, in the place of correction. Lift your voice and pray to God. Pray to God. Oh Lord, help me, Lord, to humble myself. Help me 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 to humble myself. Lord, deliver me, Lord, from pride. Deliver me, Lord, from pride. Deliver me, Lord, from pride. Lift your voice and cry to God. That devil is a liar. That devil is a liar. Surrender, Lord, to your processing, Lord, to your perfection, Lord. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus, Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Child of God, Elisha came from a rich home. They had oxen. They had all manner of wealth. They even whatever they are so rich that they even set forth for him. But God took him to a man who had no house, who had absolutely nothing. They didn't even connect him to any father. It's just Elijah. You're going to cry to God. You don't know where God is taking you to. You don't know your destiny. He may remove you from your comfort zone and put you in a place where you will train, where you will groom, you will be groomed according to your folk, according to your destiny, where he's taking you to. If you despise it, you are gone in this world. If you despise divine connection, no wonder when Elisha told Elijah, allow me to go and do, set forth, and tell the people, Baba. Elijah rebuked Elisha. I was angry with him. Is it a time to go and between party where God is calling you? Child of God, do you have anyone that can scold you? Look at how Elijah did not allow the wealth of Elisha to touch his man. He didn't allow Elisha to be pampered. He has been pampered in his family. Now he is in a place of training, in a place of good. He's going to perform 14 miracles in Elisha's lifetime. He didn't need betting. He didn't need a man to go to boost in him. He didn't need a place where he would be a house poor. He'll be pouring water on the hand of Elijah. Child of God, when God wants to train you, there is no room for betting. When God is training you, he's training you according to your destiny. What your destiny requires. He will not look at your face. He will not look at your background. He will not check what your passport you passed through. God Almighty is our daddy. He loves us. He loves us. And the Bible goes there. Lift your voice, God, and say, Father, forgive me, Lord. When I rejected your packaging. I did not want your type of training. I fought your type of training. Father, forgive me, Lord. Hey, Holy Ghost, have mercy on your children. Have mercy on me, Lord. Help me to embrace your plan for my life, your training program. In the mighty name of Jesus, lift your voice and cry. right now. Hey, Holy Ghost, help your people. Help your youth to pray. Help the young men to pray. Help the young women to pray. Their life is just starting. Hey, God, I'm going to let you know. Hold the Lord God Almighty. I ask the Lord, you will help us, O God, to follow your way, to receive your packaging, to receive your own, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Raka Labokosote, Leka Labababalatale, Raka Labokosote, in Jesus Christ, mighty name we have prayed. Look at what is happening today. Today, parents, they correct their children and they will still beg the child. When the child gets angry and goes to at the backyard and refuses to eat and locks up himself in the room, you still go and beg the child. That child is gone. Any child that you rebuke and the child refuses to eat, the child begins to keep malice, the child refuses to do anything in the house, the child refuses to go for morning prayer, that child needs urgent intervention. Because the child is breaking the law of honor of the parents. And anything can happen to that child. Go to cry to God. All you parents that beg your children, you have to repent today. You know you're a mother. You rebuke your child. You still go back and beg your child. You are a killer. You hate your child. Yes, you don't love your child. You are endangering your child. You are setting up your child for your child to be killed by the devil. Honor your mother, your father, that your days may be longer. That is the first commandment with a blessing. You're going to cry to God and say, Father, have mercy on me, Lord, for corrupting my child, for betting my child to death. Cry to God, all you parents, and you don't be begging your children. You're begging your children that did errors. You go and worship them. You go and buy things for them. And they are not repentant. They don't know why you are repentant. They didn't know why you repent them. They're not repentant. Cry to God and say, Father, I am sorry. I am sorry, Lord. Father, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me, Lord. I spoiled my son. I overpetted my daughter. And now I cannot control her anymore. I gave her whatever she wanted. She never took rebuke. I was the one always begging her. I called her sweet names to make her to be happy. Love her, Almighty. I am sorry, Lord. And I call her, pray for your children. Ask God for mercy for your children. Now they came and beat you back. You beat your child. Your child beat you back. Hey, Kalababala, that is not a play. It's not fun. It's not fun at all. It's dangerous. It's dangerous for that child. That child cannot make heaven. That child cannot fulfill his destiny. Hey, Kalababala, I'm so dear. I'm going to my child. On my children, oh God, all the teenagers, all these little ones, have mercy on them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Have mercy, they don't know what they're doing, Lord. Lord, they don't know what they're doing, Lord. Have mercy on our children, Lord. Deliver them, oh God, Lord, from fight. Deliver them, oh Lord, from taking laws into their hands. Deliver them, oh Lord, from high-mindedness, from pride and arrogance, and insults to their parents. Have mercy, Lord, in Jesus Christ. Mighty name we have prayed. You better pray for your conscience. Child of God, your conscience is too old. You have turned your conscience to be so old. It needs to be watered. You need the watering of God's word upon your conscience to come alive. Your conscience is dry. It's so dry. It's breaking you down. You're going to pray and say, Father, pour your living water on my conscience. Your war, so I can repent quickly. Open your mouth and cry to God. Pour water, pour water, pour water, pour water. Yeah, God, I will consult you. Pour water, Lord, on my conscience, oh God. The water of your word, your living water. Pour on my conscience, oh God. Let my conscience, oh Lord, come alive, come afresh, and begin to respond, oh God, to your rebuke, to your correction. Have mercy on me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help my children. Help all our children in the global Lord. Help us, Lord. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Child of God, are you going to put a rebuke? Or you have made yourself a king of yourself, a queen of yourself. Nobody can talk to you. People are afraid of talking to you. It is a dangerous position. Ikechi, I am sitting down here. God Almighty is raising people to talk to me. I thank God. People have come to Global Altar. God uses them to talk to me. And I thank them. And I receive all the correction, all the rebukes. And I give glory to God. You are going to cry to God, because God Almighty is calling you now to a state whereby anytime you are ready for rapture, he can blow trumpet at any time. What? You don't delay repentance. You don't delay obedience. Child of God, delayed repentance is rebellion. No rebel is entering heaven. God has just the last rebel out. Called Lucifer. There cannot be admitted any rebel again in heaven. You are going to Christ God. Do you really want to make heaven? God said, who will make heaven? He asked the question, do you want to make heaven? It's not by positive confession. It's by softness to repentance. It's by zealousness to repentance. He said, I love you that I'm coming to this secret. I'm giving you this secret. He said, be zealous. Be zealous and repent. Father! Cry to God. We know what you're so hard. You're so hard. Hey, come on, out here. You want to defend and defend and defend and defend. Who is fighting with you? Who is fighting with you? Yeah, come on, out here. It's about your soul. It's about your soul, child of God. It's about your soul. Yeah, come on, out here. Quick repentance, quick repentance, all church repentance, not ordinary, not ordinary, not ordinary. I will not delay my repentance. It will be quick, 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 quick. Urgent, urgent, urgent. Fast, 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 fast. I will not waste my time. Rekalaboko soze. Rekalakalakalataya. Help me not to repent. To repent urgently. To repent zealously. Not to waste time. Not to postpone. Not to postpone. Not to postpone. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we have prayed. Child of God, this is a practical message. Because there are some things you have to quickly report yourself. God Almighty is giving us time now to report ourselves. Go and report yourself. Report yourself to your wife. Sir, tell her what you are doing over there. Report yourself, sister, to your husband. Tell him the truth about your job. Tell him that you are building a special house. You didn't tell him about the house. It is time for you to go and report. Because the harvest, when they find out later, you will not know how you are going to handle it. And no prayer is going to help you. That time, repentance will be late. Now is the acceptable time. The Bible says, when you hear his voice, harden not your heart. They say, report it to report. You, this child, there's something to tell your parents. Go and tell your parents what you did. Guys, they report it to report. I hear it so clear. It is the time now to report. When you report yourself to God, God will cover you. It is not easy to cover sin. You cannot cover sin. You will use fig leaves. You can't be hiding. And yet, there is space. You are still being seen like Adam and Eve. Don't delay apology. When God is, there is a message going on. Don't wait till the end. As much is going on, be repenting. Don't waste time because rapture can take place during the service. Don't wait for altar call because it will change your mind. It's urgent. Somebody say urgent.
Urgent.
Urgent. Also there. Say, Father, give me the grace.
Father, give me the grace.
Every particular point in time.
Every particular point in time.
When I sin against you, Lord.
When I sin against you, Lord.
Help me to report myself. I don't want anybody to come from you. I don't want to, nobody should come from you, Lord. Don't send anybody, Lord. Help me to repent, Lord. Because the Holy Ghost is in me. God talks to us. The conscience is alive. Of urgent response, urgent response to your rebuke, to your chastening, to your chastening. Thank you, precious. precious Redeemer. Lord, we give you the glory. Lord, we give you the honor. We worship you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Child of God, lift your voice and appreciate God. This is love. This is love. This is love. Lord, come here. The love of God is here. Now give us a secret. Secret of heaven. Is quick repentance. Zealousness in repentance. No wasting time. Quickly say, Lord, I am sorry. Fast. No long story. Not explaining anything. Nothing to say. Don't fall on your face. I say, I'm sorry, Lord. It attracts mercy. It attracts the mercy of God. It attracts the help of God. It attracts the strength of God. Don't waste time again, child of God. Let's not be proud. Let's not waste time. This is the time that God has shut us up. So open us to ourselves. To help us to make heaven at last. Hey, Kalacha Nagaliba Kusute. Raka Tanagaliba Kusute. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Precious family, we give God the praise for helping us, but we are still going to pray. Privately, we'll be praying. Because God Almighty said, no more playing church. No more playing Christianity. It is time to prepare for heaven. And the moment we can succeed, he said, repent quickly. Once it comes to you, don't waste time. Don't give it any reason. Don't give it any trace of any reason why it has to be done. All you need to do is say, Lord, I am sorry. Fall before his face. You will see what God will do in your life. As we humble ourselves before him in the mighty name of Jesus
Christ.
God bless you, mommy and daddy. God bless you, everyone over there.
Amen.
All the people of God, God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless
Amen.
You. By the grace of God, we are resuming again in another 2 hours by 6 p.m. for the second session.
Amen.
Because God has a lot to give to us.
Amen.
Wants to feed us.
Yes,
wants to strengthen us.
Amen.
God bless you. God preserve you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Love you plenty, plenty.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
We pray, say, Father.
Father.
Surround me with salty Christians.
Surround me with salty Christians.
Who will not allow sugar in my life?
Who will not allow sugar in my life?
Who will tell me as it is?
Who will tell me as it is?
And give me opportunity to repent.
And give me opportunity to
lift your voice and cry to God, child of God. Sugar preacher. I don't want sugar Christian. I don't want sugar daddy. I don't want sugar mommy. I want salt. I want salt. I want salt. I want salt, Lord. I will have a body to repent to God. To make heaven at last. I want salt to God. Rika Baba Kusuta Ganataya. Rika Telagalataya. Oh, Rika Telagalataya. Lord, I give you glory. Lord, I give you honor. Rika Baba Kusuta Ganataya. Oh, I'm pressing on the upward way. Lord, lift me up. Lagalabo Sotra, Rakata Lagalabo Sotra, Lipra.